This is a sample lesson from my introduction to Procreate Dreams animation course, where I walk through 12 beginner-friendly exercises. To find more information, check out the link below. And I hope you enjoy it. We have done a lot of hard work, and I'm gonna slow down a bit in this lesson to make this dreamy, easy, relaxing animation. It's super simple, probably the easiest of all. Let's head over to the template. For this animation, we actually don't need the grid at all, so I'm just gonna turn it off. I'm gonna create a new track for my drawing. If you remember all the different color blocks, those are drawings. So I'm just gonna go to the draw mode, even just do full screen so I can see the flip book. But we're only gonna make one frame. So just pick your favorite color and use your favorite brush, start drawing. The only thing to remember is to cover a larger area than you think is necessary. So here is the size of our stage. I'm gonna go further because when you move things around, you don't want the empty space to show. You can make your brush bigger to be more efficient. And then just build your colors gradually. Technically, you can create more layers by tapping on the layers panel here to add more layers. But for this piece of animation, one layer is what I need. So I'm just gonna go around and just keep on drawing. You can vary the brush size to create different looks. Okay, like this. Maybe I wanna add some thinner strips in the middle. There's no right or wrong way to do it. All these colors are going to be like blurred into a colorful blob. So it's really, really hard to mess up. Can even add on top of the original color. Just one layer. If you have taken any of my illustration class, you know that I really advocate for having as many layers as possible for illustration. So it's really rare for me to draw everything on one layer. Okay, I'm gonna stop here. I can do this forever. Press done to exit out of the draw mode. So now we're done with coloring. As you can see, the colored area is almost like four times as large as the stage. I'm gonna hit done. And then we have this one tiny frame on our timeline. What I'm gonna do next is to use perform mode. Technically, you can just keep planting the different keyframes for movement, but in this case, we just want things to move around. There's no particular timing that we need to keep in mind for, so I'm just gonna hit this circle to record. As soon as you tap on it, it will turn into this rectangle, or actually square. And on the upper left-hand corner, it has a blinking circle, indicates that it's ready when you are. So I'm just gonna use either finger or my pen to move it around. As soon as my finger or pen touches the screen, it will start recording. You will see the timeline will be quickly filled up. I'm just gonna move very slowly around. All right, as you can see, we already have our keyframes automatically added. So let's play. It's looking great so far. If you want to fine tune the movement, you can just two finger tap on screen to undo and then tap on your original frame. while the perform mode is still active and you change the movement. There you go. And you can also change the playback mode. Right now it's looping. When you tap on the name of your project, it goes to timeline. And you can change to loop or ping pong or just one shot. I'm going to go to ping pong because I know my last frame doesn't really match my first frame. So when I do ping pong, the jump looks smaller. There you go. A little better. And then when the keyframes are too close, you can also spread them apart so the movement is not very sudden in between these keyframes. All right, so this is the general look and feel. I'm going to add a couple of things on top of that. So first, I'm going to get out of this perform mode. So tap on the done. And then tap on the playhead icon. So first thing I'm going to do is to add blur to the whole scene. So tap on filter and then Gaussian blur. And then you can just increase the blur amount. You can add different blurring amount to the track if you want the level of blur to change. If you want to stay only at one blurry level, you can just delete the first keyframe. It will stay consistent throughout, which is the case for me. I'm going to let the blur stay at the same level, but animate the noise. So tap anywhere on the drawing and then tap on the playhead, filter, noise. So I'm going to animate the noise. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can see better because the noise is really subtle and you want it to be that way. So I'm going to increase the amount. And you can really play around to see what's your favorite noise level or pattern of noise. Okay, this looks great. I'm gonna stay here and then just move the second noise keyframe to the end and maybe even adjust the first keyframe to a stronger value. Because each type of keyframes are independent from each other, so you can keep adding onto this list. You can make it rotate or change the scale or do whatever ballet on stage. You know, you can add all kinds of animation on top of each other to achieve whatever creative goal you have. But basically, that's how I made this dreamy noise animation. And I will see you in the next lesson.